Breakpoints are like the building blocks of responsive design. A breakpoint defines a size where the design may adjust for specific layout requirements. At given breakpoint ranges, the layout adjusts to meet the screen size and/or device orientation that a user is using. Let's look at a concrete example from Warby Parker, an eyeglass company. At the desktop breakpoint or size, we see three columns of product images. When we then look at the mobile breakpoint or size, we now see one column of product images. The layout has adjusted based on what breakpoint we are using. At its core, there are four basic breakpoint sizes to consider: extra small, which is phone; small, which is a tablet; medium, which is a laptop size; and large, which is for desktop. You can break these down into further specific sizes depending on your user needs. So for example, if your users consistently need to use a giant monitor to complete tasks, you'll need to account for the size in your breakpoints. Now that we've covered the what, let's talk why. There are two key benefits in UX when using breakpoints. One, they help maintain layout consistency across screen sizes, orientations, and devices. We want our users to have a consistent experience, whether they are on a laptop, a phone, or somewhere in between. And two, you are able to more efficiently communicate and work with your dev team. Breakpoints are more of a technical thing. Dev will use media queries to architect the CSS or your designs by breakpoint. So designers need to know what and how to use them in order to work within and with development. Breakpoints are vital to making your designs responsive, allowing layouts to adjust based on your user's need and viewpoint.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our virtual UX conferences that offer live hands-on UX training.